going on YouTube? Moose78 back at you with some more American Truck Simulator. We are back with my Let's Play series, Stories from the Road. We are on episode number 17. Hope you're all having a fantastic Thursday, by the way. And if you remember last episode, we stopped here at Tonopah to take our 10-hour break, get some rest, and we are continuing our trip up to Winnemucca. We are just about there. So we'll get that wrapped up today. We started out down in Phoenix. So far, we've had a pretty good run. Get all fired up here and drive in the rain. Mirrors on. Let the air build up here for a second. I did turn on the air brake simulation. Seems a lot better than when the game first came out. I don't know if they made some modifications to it, or if my settings just are a little bit more accurate, maybe a little bit better. But when the game first came out and I turned on air brake simulation, I was having failures constantly. Now it's pretty solid, so. Take a look around the interior, I guess. Gloomy rainy day here in ATS. There we go. Let's get after it. Probably could have made it. But in the interest of safety, we went ahead and waited. Still doing good on fuel, not gonna worry about stopping. Put some Radex on my windows. Seems like this would be an ideal spot for a traffic light. I stay over in the left-hand lane, I should be good. Yippers! Thank you. closing in on Winnemucca. So far, pretty good trip. Rain stopping, that's good. Run off the road, turn off the windshield wipers. Arizona, maybe after this, see what's available. So far, the few times I have left Arizona, it's just been up into Nevada a little bit, then right back into Arizona, just because I'm loving that expansion so much. I think this is the longest trip I've taken so far. I think the first leg of this took just right around about a half an hour or so. So a nice improvement from, at least to me it seems like a nice improvement from what we had in the first two states. Seems like the trips are taking a little bit longer. Again, I don't know if that's a placebo effect or if they actually did change the scale a little bit somewhere. Like maybe in Arizona. Drop a gear there and pick up some RPMs. Someone mentioned something about Washington. I'd be okay with that. Get up into the Pacific Northwest. I kind of imagine, at least to me, it kind of makes sense to kind of fill out the west part of the map, the west coast and all that stuff, before you start expanding east a whole lot. So maybe like Washington and Oregon next, then start heading east again a little bit. And maybe we'll start getting updates a little bit more frequent. Seems like they're starting to get stuff dialed in pretty good, so. Checked. checked the other day and it wasn't updated yet. But the MHA Pro Map should be updated for 1.3 here pretty soon. So that'd be nice to get that back in, action. I did see Rookie 31st did get the iFixes update, and he's got it all in one nice convenient pack now. That's updated for 1.3, and I do have that in game now. Miss them all. Looks like a storm brewing up ahead. But I just like driving on these two-lane roads a lot more than I think anything else in the game. A lot more scenic. Kind of has that Americana feel to it. Be nice though as they continue to expand the maps and everything to make those long runs out on the interstate though too. appreciate that. Fuel economy is getting a little bit better. We're up to 6.1 now. I don't know what it was, but it's kind of weird. When I was driving the W900 the other night, messing around with it, I was getting way better fuel economy in that with like a 6.25 cat versus this with a 550 horsepower. I think I got a Cummins or a Detroit in this. Can't remember which one offhand. Yikes. Not paying attention about blew past the exit here. I'll wait for him. He would have done the same for me. I know he would have. Just about to the destination, and so far we're not there yet, so anything's possible, but so far no incidents. I could float that in there, but not so much. Almost being a little too cautious. Walbert from here. Looks to be one of the distribution centers, so that's good. Much easier to park than the little grocery stores. Okay. All right. Where do you need it? Let's play it safe. I'm in a hurry. I am gonna press my luck. And we're gonna go for the big boy 90 XP. I'm gonna regret this, I know it right now. Gonna jinx us. We had a pretty good run going so far. That's about all to go to hell in a handbasket. Because I'm gonna try to back this thing in to the crazy where do you want it spot. Might not be that bad. This doesn't seem Gosh, they went all the way freaking down there, don't they? Why wouldn't they? How many trailers are down there? All of them? Ugh. Ugh. Stop that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna skip parking this big ol' hog beast over there, like in the most difficult spot ever. Yep. Yeah, that was just gonna get way out of hand. Ooh, almost a level 188. See what we got coming out of Winnemucca for some contracts. Over to Elko. Over to Elko. Elko's a hotbed today. Reno. Sacramento. I really don't want to go into California. Maybe sneak over to Truckee. Kind of looking for something a little bit different though, too. That flat bed of pipes going over to Elko look kind of cool. Go down to Oxnard. Los Angeles. Carlsbad. Ooh, it's way down south. So I might just grab that little flatbed going to Elko and call it a day. Some hay going way down to Camp Verde. Yeah, let's go back and grab that. When's that expire? Oh, yeah. 7 hours and 16 minutes. Ooh, 41,000 pounds. I'll take that. Picking up Vitamin, going over to Plaster and Sons. Let's do it. Mix it up a little bit and get some flatbed action in. We don't do that a whole lot. Pretty much been sticking to the dry vans and reefer trailers. So we'll throw in some variety. I've not checked and see if Bart's updated his Fontaine flatbed yet for 1.3. And I've not taken the time to update it myself for 1.3. I know after I updated it in open beta, I was getting some errors with it. Something to do with the flares or something. So that could have been something on my end, but I took that out. But I know that's a trailer I did pull quite a bit there for a while. Let's see a little better. I just was not going to back that trailer in there. That was not going to end well. No real good way to do that. donuts. Sounds good right about now. So maybe after we drop this off in Elko, we'll start to head back down towards Nevada. Or Arizona, rather. We're in Nevada, of course. There we go. Bitumen. Gameplay. Team's off. Route, automatic. Oh, okay. Yeah, it didn't seem like say the way it did it. Last episode, we hooked up. It didn't couple right. Well, it just coupled like it, used to without the advanced trailer coupling on. That's because it wasn't. Yeah, we are way off apparently. Maybe not that far off. Can't be that far off. Plus, I have to go back and, which I wouldn't think I would. Update 579 again, because I did have it updated with all the collision boxes and everything on there. Oh no, I'm just off just a little bit. Just a little bit. Yeah, you pretty much gotta be dead nuts on. So it's not gonna couple. Nice looking flatbed, matches the truck. Make sure we clear this other flatbed over here next to us. Quick run over Elko, and we should be good. kind of different now, pulling a van of sorts. Trying to make this up a little bit more. Yeah, this is safe. Nobody stops. Nobody. Free for all. This thing is going to pull like a bear going up that. Not too bad. Looks like it's about to the very top. Come on, girl. Come on now. You can do it. Ah, good. We got one of the safe on ramps. Got a little bit of a merge lane. Yeah, I can definitely tell this thing is pretty heavy. Myself into trouble. Get out here in the hammer lane, think I got places to go and people to see, and then next thing I know, I'm missing my exit, crashing 64 cars and raising all sorts of hell. And I can see the destination up ahead. Shabby. Not too shabby. Come on, go, 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 go. Kidding me. Let's see if I can't. Yeah. Honk at me again, pal. Damn tanker just had to stop just enough short to screw me there. Had he moved up just a skosh, would have been perfectly fine. Just a little bit. But outside of that, yeah, the last couple runs have been pretty successful. Maybe I'm finally getting gooder. More betterist. Bus was coming after me for a second. What kind of crazy parking job can we do here? Maybe that's not so bad. We'll give it a shot. Shot-a-roo. That shouldn't be too bad. Just kind of go around in a circle and see if I can't get stuck on something. Just pull up and back straight in. That is the plan, anyways. So, I don't know, some of these used to be like a big old mound of dirt there. Just wonder if they took that out. So far, so good. Not getting hung up on anything. Crikey! This just might work. All this stuff. Not a problem. Whoopsie. I need to go back into my options here real quick. Sorry, guys. Buttons. I was doing something the other day and forgot that I had that mapped to my trailer brake. There we go. as being super sensitive. It was in gear, but it just wasn't registering for some reason. Oh, yeah, we got this. We got it. Go. Hop out here so we can see it decouple. And there we go. All right, guys, that's going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. As always, thanks for stopping by, hanging out. If you like today's video, go ahead and give it a like and a share. It just helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. If you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. But be sure to tune in next Tuesday for another episode of Stories from the Road. We do this every Tuesday and Thursday, by the way. And be sure to tune in on Wednesdays where I just upload some plain old gameplay footage without any commentary. But I'm going to cut out of here for now, guys. Until the next one, take care, and we'll be seeing you. Hey, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please take a moment and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, click on the link in the description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, click my NoScope affiliate link also down in the description. And if you want more ATS content, click on the video to check out my Stories from the Road playlist. Thanks, and we'll catch you in the next one.